AJSpeller.com. In today's tutorial, we're going to revisit a tutorial where we used different technology to show the graph. This time we're going to use the TI-84C. So we need to find the equations of both tangent lines to the graph of the ellipse that passes through the point 0,4, where 0,4 is not on the ellipse. And here's the basic sketch here. We have the tangent line. This is the first tangent line with the positive slope. This here is the tangent line with the negative slope. This here is the original equation for the ellipse. And then here I've actually rewritten that equation, removing the denominators. With the TI-84, you have to have your equations in the explicit format. Right now it's in the implicit format. So we need to have our dependent variable y on the left-hand side and our independent variables x on the right-hand side. So basically we're just going to solve for y. So to do that, we need to subtract 9x squared from both sides, so we end up with a 4y squared is equal to 36 minus 9x squared. Now to get the y squared by itself, we divide each term by 4. In doing so, these 4s cancel, and I'm left with y squared is equal to, and then I can simplify here on the right hand side, 36 divided by 4 leaves me with 9 minus, and I'm going to rewrite this second term here. All right, I don't want y squared, I just want y, so I need to take the square root of both sides of this equation. In doing so, y squared becomes y, and then I have a positive and negative expression here, 9 minus 9x squared over 4. All right, with the TI-84, I'm going to have to actually have two equations in the calculator. The positive equation is going to show the top portion of the ellipse. The negative equation is going to show the bottom portion of the ellipse. All right, I have a similar issue here with the tangent lines, the positive tangent and the negative tangent, where they're not in explicit format. To make these explicit, all I need to do is just get this negative 4 from the left-hand side. So I'm just going to add 4 to both sides. So for the positive, it becomes y is equal to square root 7/4 x plus 4. And when I do the same thing on the equation with the negative, again, those 4s cancel. And I have y is equal to negative square root 7/4 x plus 4. All right, now let's take a look at the calculator so that we can see how this looks. All right, if you look, you see I already have the equations in place. I've got these two, y1 is for the top part of the ellipse, y1 is for the bottom part of the ellipse. I've turned off the two tangents momentarily. So let's go ahead and draw the graph. All right, we see that's the positive in blue, the negative in red, and I also have a box here showing the point 0,4. All right, let's go back to the equations. Let's turn on the tangent lines. So we go down, just go over the equal signs, and press enter. Once you see the bold around it, that lets you know that that is enabled or toggled on. So this here is the positive tangent line, the tangent line with a positive slope. Here's the tangent line with the negative slope. All right, toggle that one on, and now let's go back and graph. All right, we see that's drawn in there, and we see that's drawn in there. So this here is how it would look using the TI-84, and then let's go over to the more powerful online graphing tool. If you look here, the third equation and fourth equations, I've actually separated these so that this is the top part of the ellipse, this is the bottom part. And matter of fact, let me turn off the implicit version of it. So we see here we have the first equation is for the positive part of the ellipse. This fourth equation is for the negative part of the ellipse. And as a matter of fact, let's go ahead and make these changes here too. So let's get rid of the negative 4 there and end up adding 4 to both sides. And then let's come down here and do the same thing. Get rid of the negative 4 and end up adding 4 to both sides, and you see that, and you see that those equations are equivalent. All right, so this here is just a quick tutorial showing how to use the TI-84 as your technology to visualize what's going on with this particular question, and to also verify your work. As always, thank you for watching another video by ajspreller.com, and have a great day.